Hello,
Wonderful to see you here. Welcome.
thank you, thank you. Happy to be back.
How have you been? How has life been post Liberate? What are you up to, and what happened after the Liberate training?
Yeah, I feel like a lot's happened. God, that was 2021. It's been 3 years now. I've moved a couple times. I have a little boy now, Cameron. He's 2 years old. So,
Wow.
embracing fatherhood, that's really been amazing. It's probably been my favorite part over the last couple years. Yeah, since graduating, launching my coaching business, and I'm sure we'll talk about it more, but one of the funny things is you kind of start and you're gung-ho about it and everything's moving forward. You definitely have some deviations. Where I probably put things down for a little bit, but I definitely think in the last probably 6 months or so, I really picked things back up and there's been a lot of momentum. And I just really enjoy the process of getting back into it and actually making this something that I'm doing full time now. So I
Let's
really
back up a
enjoyed it.
little bit. How about if we back up and talk a little bit about what you were doing before Liberate and maybe what happened during and shortly after then, and we can just sort of get a snapshot of that change or transformation that you went through.
Yeah, I always remember the first call that I did with you, Sarah. It was kind of right when the pandemic had kicked off. So I was a CEO of a film distribution business in Nigeria at the time, from about 2018 to 2020. So we were handling distribution and marketing, for theatrical releases for Sony, Paramount, Universal, and a lot of local titles as well. It was a very growing and budding cinema market in Nigeria. So I did that for about 2 years. And I'd actually moved back to Georgia at the beginning of the pandemic. Unfortunately, my mother had gotten quite sick and ultimately passed around the time a lot of the lockdowns had kicked off. And that was actually one of the big things that spurred a lot of the self-discovery that I was going through, finding meditation, mindfulness practices, going to therapy for the first time. And I remember us talking, I believe it was that spring or summer, and ultimately finding the Liberate program. I was at a point where I was trying to find myself. I was trying to better understand myself, not just what I was going through my grief, but trying to understand what it is I actually want. I felt like I had achieved a lot at a fairly young age, and I had a very budding career. On paper, everything looked like it was going in the right direction, but there was definitely a lot of feelings of anxiety, just not being sure if what I was doing is what I actually wanted. I was filling in a lot of the gaps for other people, and all those questions kind of came to me around the time that I found Liberate. And then that's when my self-discovery journey really launched from there once we started the program.
How did you feel when you were going through Liberate during this time? Because you didn't necessarily have an intention, perhaps, to teach. It was more to go into your own process. What were you feeling about that?
Yeah, it there was a part that was exciting, but there was also a lot of it that was really uncomfortable, right? I remember I had actually walked away from my job, right? And like I'd walked away from the job that was supposed to be the thing that I continued to do, right? And there was so much uncertainty at that time. Going through the self-discovery journey for me was, okay, how do I believe I was about 28, 29 at the time. How do I go through this and actually figure out who I am and what I want? So there's a lot of uncomfortability coming up, I think, particularly in those first couple weeks. But as I went through it, I think one of the big things that happened was like it was a big kind of just dropping of your shoulders, just relieving so much of that tension that I'd either put on myself or I allowed other people to put on me. I was definitely curious about coaching. I like the idea of it. I wasn't 100% sure that that's the thing that I was going to be doing in terms of my profession and my career. But there was also just a knowing that I was walking in the right direction.
Was there a time where a switch happened for you where you thought, this is something I would like to do? And when was that time for you?
So I can't remember exactly if it was just before, right around the time that we were actually finishing the program. And I remember, I believe I was having a conversation with, I was having a conversation with my cousin, who's like my best friend. We literally talk every day. And, you know, we have one of those relationships where we share everything with each other. And, you know, he was giving me one of those pep talks. I was kind of in my head about something. And, you know, I think I realized all of the work that I've been doing up until that point, how I approach life, how I approach relationships, and kind of this desire, not just to be a helpful person, but helping people see the light that they have within themselves, the same way that I was able to kind of find my light again, because it had felt lost for a while. I think that's when there was kind of a shift where I understood, I gained the skill set that I needed to be able to do that with other people. I had already done a lot of the work. The work is never finished, but I had already done a lot of the work in my own self-discovery, better understanding myself, how I wanted to actually structure my life. And I realized by me doing that for myself, I can help other people do that as well. And I think that's when the tide kind of turned for me. I think hearing from a trusted friend, hearing that other perspective, and it wasn't just my internal monologue, I think that helps kind of make a shift for me. Yeah.
Wonderful. Well, thank you for sharing, Jared. Tell us a little bit about what's happening for you now, maybe even how you've been able to take your practice into your life, you know, your family life, being a father, and how that's gone into now your professional life.
Yeah, you know, so there's a few things that come to mind. One, obviously, the meditation piece. There's certainly been times where I haven't been as consistent with my own practice. But I think one of the things that I found when I actually give myself that dedicated time, whether it's first thing in the morning or before I go to bed, or like one thing I started to do quite a bit is like after I do my workouts, I spend 10, 15 minutes meditating, like being very present in my body. And I definitely found when I'm doing that consistently, I start kind of taking note of how I'm showing up in other aspects of my life. And I think about fatherhood quite a bit. So much of it is allowing yourself to be present. You know, it's easy to kind of get into your head of, oh man, I can't wait till he grows up. I can't wait till he's kind of speaking in full sentences. We can actually have a conversation. And the first time we can go outside and throw the ball. And those are all beautiful things that I can't wait to happen. But allowing myself to be present in the moment and enjoying all the things that my son can do now and the way that we can engage with each other now, I found so much joy in that. I tell people every day, it is so hard raising a little person, but it's honestly the coolest thing that you can do. Like, there's nothing better than like bringing someone into this world, this little mini me, your little, I like to call my little best friend, you know, because he just wants to play. He just, and you know, that's what's so amazing about mindfulness and meditation, being presently engaged. He just wants to have a good time. You know, he taps you on your knee and he wants to play. Like, being fully present with that, I have found so much joy in that. And I've seen how that translates into my work, whether I'm coaching someone. When I really allow myself to be centered going into my sessions and fully engage with the energy that's within our session, those have always been the sessions that have been the most effective. Not the ones where I sit and prep and, okay, I want to do these four exercises with my client and, you know, I want to map all these things out. those things can be helpful. But when you are fully present and engaged working with someone, whether it be your coaching practice or what other work that you do, you start to find actual joy even when it is work. And I always think of, you know, it's a quote from Ram Dass.
You had other certifications as well, correct? Coaching.
Well, now I'm going through another certification. At the time of doing Liberate, that was my first one.
Okay.
I am doing another certification that's a little bit more based for leadership and executive coaching. But that whole quote of like, when you realize that work is really play, that's always present for me. And I've kind of taken that into really all of my interactions. Yeah.
And what are you finding now in your work? What are you focused on now? And then we're going to open this up to questions for people who are here in the community.
So I think what I'm finding is when you give that level of focus to an individual's self-awareness, their own self-discovery journey, and ultimately authenticity. Authenticity is what's been on my mind quite a bit, particularly these last couple months. Helping people live a more authentic life, being really comfortable and confident with being themselves. The positive ripple effect from that is you can't quantify it. When you get truly comfortable with being the authentic version of yourself, you will show up so much better in every other part of your life. So I think when I first started coaching, I tried to be very specific on the topics or goals that a client would come to me with. But now I'm really centering it on making sure that my client feels comfortable and confident being themselves as often as possible. And everything else just kind of stacks together.
And how can people find you?
Langley Coaching and Consulting. That's the name of my business. And most of my social media reflects that.
Maybe like a little bit more specificity, just before you go, a little more specificity and story around like how you're formulating your work now or how you're getting work and finding clients, you know?
Yeah, I think one of the things that started to work for me, so in general, you know, sharing content on social media, I think one end, it's certainly helpful finding some kind of a niche, right, that you lock into. I would say one thing that's been really helpful for me is really identifying what your coaching philosophy is, right? How you approach all your sessions. So a lot of the authenticity that I talk about, that kind of becomes the bedrock for a lot of the content that I put out. So I do share a lot of my meditations on TikTok and Instagram. On LinkedIn, my content is probably a little bit more corporate. There is a lot more corporate people on there. And LinkedIn has actually been where I've probably found the majority of my clients so far. And then of course, is referrals. Once you get a couple successful engagements under your belt, always ask for the referral. Always ask people to share what their experience has been and getting those testimonials. That's always been really helpful. But ultimately, getting comfortable sharing your story, sharing your voice, sharing your coaching philosophy on whatever platform that you prefer, just getting comfortable doing that, I think, has been very helpful.
You've done a great job at that,
Jared. Thank you.
You really have.
Hey, I learned from the best. Oh.
Well, maybe would you be open to sharing a minute of meditation with us before we transition to Nyssa? Okay. Anything else you'd like to say? Any last parting words?
One last thing I'll share, because it was funny you asked about other certifications. I won't discourage anyone from doing additional certifications. The one piece of advice that I'll give, if you do go down that route, I would say do it for a very specific reason. If there's like a very specific type of client that you want to work with, or there's a certain level of certification you need for a role, that would make sense. But what I've learned almost finishing the certification I'm doing now, the framework and the foundation for coaching is everything that you're going to learn from Sura. So have full confidence that what you're learning in this program or any of the programs you take from Sura, essentially is the same framework when it comes to coaching, right? You can certainly expand on it and you can get very specific in certain topics, which can be helpful, but the foundation is essentially the same. So that might save you some money.
It's good to hear that. That's interesting feedback. And yeah, you'd have to wonder, because I do notice that a lot of people that come through the training have multiple certifications, and they've often gone through other coaching programs, and there are different dimensions to every certification.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. But the foundation is always, it's either the same or it's quite similar. Yeah.
Mm, agree. I'd have to agree on that. Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much, Jared.
Yeah.
And if you don't mind guiding us through a minute of meditation where you've been focusing, that would be lovely.
Sure. Yeah,
and
I'd be
thank
happy
you
to.
So much for your time and your energy. It's been amazing to see you again.
Of course. I always look out for those emails from Chella. Whatever she asks, you know I'm going to say yes. I appreciate you asking, but my answer has always been yes. Okay. So let's allow ourselves to get into a brief meditation. If you're comfortable, just close your eyes or give yourself a very soft gaze. And I'd like us to start by taking a very deep breath together, allowing yourself to expand through your belly, allowing yourself to fall as you breathe out. You take your first deep breath in. Breathe out. Take one more deep breath in. Breathe out. Allow your body to find its natural rhythm, allowing yourself to breathe exactly how you want to breathe. And if we set a desire or a goal to be more authentic, we may always start with our breath. Our breath is the most natural movement that we have control over. By finding awareness and conscious intention behind our breath, we may find deeper connection to our true selves. Allow yourself to be fully present within your body. And I would like to remind you of something that you all know, that everything that you desire, everything that you need, is already yours. There's nothing that you have to do or search for that isn't already within yourself. Find peace, comfort, and knowledge within yourself by simply breathing and sitting within your own silence. I invite you to take one last deep breath with me, breathing in, breathe out. And when you're ready, you can open your eyes. Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much, Jared. Thank you for your work and your service and this beautiful meditation. I really felt it.
Yeah. Thank you, guys. You are all doing very beautiful and amazing work. Just as much as the world needed it in 2020 and 2021, it's still very much relevant and necessary today. So I encourage you all to continue walking on your path. You're all doing amazing.